Welcome back to The Witcher 3. Let's continue to pursue this dreamer quest. Let's go meet her at the Golden Sturgeon. Hopefully she's collected her thoughts by now. Oh, except I think I need to spend a character point, right? A skill point? Yes, that's right, I just leveled up. Alright, let's see. Let's put another point into refreshment. Heal 50% of maximum vitality with every potion. Nice. That's going to be really helpful, especially once it's maxed out. Healing 25% of your max health. That's pretty damn good. And that's just instant. I like it. I like it a lot. Okay. Oh, you know, I should probably put my clothes on. Let's make sure I put the right clothes on. Yes, yes.
Oh,
what?
I love the sound that shady individual made when I shoved him. It's like, oh!
Everyone's always on me.
I wonder how many shove sounds they made for all the people, for the NPCs. Oh, she's upstairs.
Hey, Whitey. Why'd your hair go white?
No.
Whoa. Incense? It's awfully smoky in here.
A dream in here.
Never witnessed a seance like this before, let alone participated.
I will guide you. We must first achieve a kind of mental accord. I must ask some questions. You must answer them. It's important you're truthful. Answer from your heart.
Your gift. Tell me how it works.
It's hard to describe. To start with, I must gain an understanding of the bond between the person and the object I'm to dream about. I ask questions. Try to flesh out feelings, emotions. Truth is essential in this. And though most who come to me acknowledge that, many refuse to speak openly of certain matters. Apart from which, they remain unaware of others, further obscuring things.
What do you see in your dreams?
I don't. It's my client who sees. My gift lies in summoning the right dreams. At times, nightmares or strong desires impose themselves on true events. It takes skill to separate seed from chaff.
Oh god, do you think she's gonna find out that I'm actually... I've got kind of a thing for water hags? Oh god. Alright, let's do this. I hope she doesn't find out.
Let's begin.
To start with, tell me a memory you have of this woman.
What for?
Do as I ask, please. I need the strongest, most complete memory you have of...
Ciri. The woman's name is Ciri.
Ooh, look at that ball. Looks like water reflection refraction shader. Alright, let's be open, let's be honest.
I accepted a job once. Did it. Asked to choose my reward, I invoked the law of surprise. Never thought I'd actually meet the child promised to me at that time. Years later, I was in the Broccolon Forest. Happened on a girl there, didn't know who she was. The Dryads wanted to keep her, turn her into one of their own. But the Waters of Oblivion, they failed in her case. Ciri came out of Broccolon with me. I sent her back to her grandmother then. But already, I felt bound to her.
By destiny.
By something more.
Thank you. Would you be willing to share another memory?
Let's just share everything.
Yes.
No need to rush. We have time.
Ciri was orphaned during the Second War with Nilfgaard. Had no idea what to do with a young girl. So I did what I would have done with a boy and took her to Kaer Morhen. Figured some physical training, sword work, development of her stamina, couldn't hurt. I remember her standing on a crumbling wall. A stone came loose, she lost her footing. Caught her at the last possible instant. Strongest memory, though, is of her coming out of her room one day, wearing a dress and claiming she was indisposed. Knew then that Ciri was maturing. It was unavoidable. I was lost in the face of that.
I see. Do you wish to tell me anything more?
Yes, I think so.
In that case, I'm listening.
It was after her time training at Kaer Morhen. After the moment when Yennefer first called Ciri her daughter. We'd been separated. I knew she was in danger. I dreamt of her multiple times. I found her at Stiga Castle. She'd gone there to free Yen and gotten herself captured in the process. They wanted to hurt her. I remember fighting side by side with Ciri on stairs slippery from blood. It was the first time she ever deflected a crossbow bolt with her sword. Told her never to try it again.
These memories, they're intense. Do you wish to continue?
I have more to say.
Then please do.
It was in Rivia. The second war with Nilfgaard had just ended. There was still tension in the air. For gods know what reason, race riots erupted in the town. I tried to do something, but couldn't stop a riled crowd. A boy with a pitchfork. He ran it right through my gut. Yennefer lay dying as well. Ciri had us carried onto a boat. We sailed to a place where apple trees bloom eternal. She left us there. It was the last time I saw her.
You claim the woman has abilities. Tell me about them.
They call her the Lady of Space and Time. That sounds so cheesy.
She's a child of the Elder Blood.
A descendant of Bloody Falker. The rebel burned at the stake. The prophecies claim the world's destroyer will be born of the Firebrand's cursed blood.
Pure legend.
No one a legend transforms into prophecy when it gains believers. I think you're right to be reticent in talking about the woman. I see. Do you wish to say more?
Is there any more to say? I think that was it. Let's see.
Yeah, there's something else.
Do they actually call her the Lady of Space and Time?
They call Ciri the Lady of Space and Time. Once I asked Yennefer why, she travels between worlds. Turns out I don't know how to talk about it. Didn't really understand much of what Yen told me. I just know there's more to it than traveling to different places, and that Ciri carries immense power in her blood.
I see. Do you wish to say more?
Yeah, there's something else. I remember Ciri having trouble controlling her abilities. Yennefer tried to teach her to cast simple spells, and Ciri destroyed a shed near the temple where they were. Really upset her, but it was just an old shed. I know it took her a while to gain control, and frankly, I doubt she controls her abilities fully to this day.
I see. Do you wish to say more?
No. Can we start?
Naturally. I knew you cared about her. But your tone, the emotions you so carefully conceal.
Let's continue, please.
Make yourself comfortable and try to relax. You must take my hand and talk of Ciri. Tell me where you think she might be. Who could be at her side?
If Ciri couldn't find me, I'm sure she would have looked for another friend.
Who do you mean?
Dandelion or Yennefer and Triss? Okay, there's something I want to clear up. And I'm going to do it right now. In the last episode, Triss asked me about Yennefer, and I said that I wasn't sure how... What was it, like, I wasn't sure how Yennefer was doing or something like that. And I said that I don't remember meeting Yennefer. All these mentions of Yennefer and casting spells and stuff are making me think that Yennefer is not who I thought she was. I think I mixed her up with somebody else. So, give me one second. Aha! I totally mixed Yennefer up with somebody else. I don't know why. For some reason, every time I heard the word Yennefer, the picture that came to mind was Shawnee. I don't know if you remember Shawnee. I don't remember that much about her. I just know that she was an elf woman with, I think, orange hair. For some reason, every time I heard Yennefer, I thought Shawnee. I don't know why. Yeah, okay, I know who Yennefer is now. Also, her arm keeps glitching out every couple seconds or so. But anyway, Yennefer and Triss or Dandelion? Honestly, who the hell would go to Dandelion for help? Can Dandelion help anybody? I think all Dandelion does is get himself and others in trouble. He's a complete jackass. No, I don't think she'd go to Dandelion.
Yennefer wasn't in Novigrad. Triss was. But Ciri never found her. Maybe Dandelion? They liked each other a lot.
Are we supposed to be able to hear his voice? I swear he's talking, but I don't hear his voice.
The dreams can multiply, show the past as well as the future.
The swallow, it symbolizes Ciri. She contacted Dandelion. I didn't know he was in town.
The poet heard about him. Someone left him the rosemary and thyme in their will.
The rosemary and thyme? Where's that?
As you enter the city through the red light district, you come upon a bridge. The rosemary is just past it.
Dandelion inherited a brothel?
So I've heard.
God. Oh God, Dandelion. How disturbingly appropriate. Dandelion is such a douchebag.
Thanks for your help.
Good luck, Witcher. I hope you find your Ciri.
Enlist again. Not for a voyage through those walls. Must have been my
page.
Help some fellas out, Master. We're a bit of coin short another round.
Cause we're comrades, see? Witcher, ain't you? We're butchers. You slaughter, we slaughter.
Except witchers earn more. Old villagers pitch in. Lords open their purses. Ladies do light with their legs.
Guess I've been to the wrong villages. Dealt with the wrong lords and ladies.
Come on, don't make us beg. What's the wish you for, anyways? It's to help men in need.
Yeah, this is a threat. This is not begging. They have clubs. Drunk idiots. I'm not giving them a damn cent. Cents, I don't even think cents exist in this currency. I'm not giving them any monies.
Believe me, doing you a big favor by not giving you coin. Now let me through.
Whoa! Master! You best watch your words. We share a trade, but that don't mean you can treat us like dogs!
Shut it! You'll bring misfortune on us. He's a witcher, can't you see?
Who wouldn't like to be treated like a dog? Get food and get petted all the time?
Out of my way.
We won't do it!
I will.
I'll not take orders from anyone! In fact, not the least of fear to teach a witcher some manners!
Not your lucky day.
This fool is never gonna get a single hit on me.
Enough. We've seen your point, Master.
Go home. You're done here.
Riveting. Absolutely riveting.
You always wear tight trousers.
Not all the time. Sometimes I don't wear any pants at all.
Wanna dip your dingle? Like a raw wound.
Did she just say, wanna dip your dingle? What the hell kind of a euphemism is that for a dick? Dingle? Hold on, I think did we get another quest too? I know we got broken flowers. I thought there's another one though. Was it this? No. Whatever, let's just stick with this.
Ow!
What the hell? Oh, hey. Fight me. I don't need no pants. Still got a good amount of oil left on there. Lubed and ready to go, motherfucker! Have some poison! Just gonna stand there and die? Cool with me. Did you just hiss at me? Oh my god! That is disgusting! Ew.
Let's end this.
Jesus. Oh, I meant to dodge. Okay. I'm not sure what killed him. He must have been poisoned. That was so disgusting, the way he just... the entire fucking top half of his body exploded when I threw that grape shot. Oh. The Rosemary and Thyme, the hottest spot in Novigrad. I have a feeling... nudity is incoming. Well, let's prepare ourselves. Gotta fit in with the locals.
But there's also crippled kids.
Will you what?
The gods have heard the land's cry. Its people's long wait is over. King Radovid will save the north.
Youth these days.
Robb Stark, take back the north!
Aw, it's locked. I guess this is the back door.
I'll never come back, you stink!
What the hell's going on in there?
Next time I'll rip your fucking legs off and shove them up your ass till you've toes for teeth!
Hey, isn't that... I forgot his name. The dude that always hangs around Dandelion. What is his name?
You're out in the nick of time, as always!
Zoltan.
Zoltan.
With your boot to someone's ass, as always. Who were those men?
Local color. I wasn't going more than a moment. Long enough for them to turn our home into theirs. All right. Time for some spring cleaning. I've got to boot them all out. Care to join me?
I would love to.
With pleasure.
You're in for it. Chase around him! Gotta get around him! Hey, Cap!
Reminds me of our days of yore.
Yeah, it's almost like we never left Bergen.
Oh, look at me!
Leg it!
I'll miss a woman.
Ah, please. That went well. Now we can greet each other like the gods ordained. Ages, pal.
Hey, Zoltan. You look good.
Training plenty lately. What with the war on, no Mahakaman meat to be found, but Redanian lagers standing in just fine. You, though, you've withered a bit. Something worrying you?
It's about Ciri. I know she came to Novigrad. Might still be here.
You mean she's come back? I'll be damned. I wonder if I'd recognize her. How many years is it now? 6? 7? But what'd she be doing here?
Hiding, probably. She might be in danger.
See her in your dreams?
Couple times. Her and the Wild Hunt.
Oh, not good.
Not at all, but I know she came here and contacted Dandelion.
We've a wee problem then.
Where's Dandelion?
I'd like to know that myself. Maybe he could explain what the hell's going on. Not just fell the return that you saw. I'm expecting to come home to a hot leg of boar and some cold ale. And what do you find instead? A shite storm. Dandelion gone, the tavern chock full of bums. I've no clue what happened.
Let's look around. Might find something that'll put us on his trail.
Prime idea. I say we start on the ground floor. It's where he sat and wrote. Aha! A note from a grateful muse.
Reading someone else's letters.
My visage red and hot. I plunged into purest ecstasy, imbibing its nectar. Your dexterous digits on my soul's yearning calls.
Was that a quest item? No, that was just a general item. When will you return to Sidaris? I hope it will be soon, for I miss you terribly. Waiting to see you again literally pains me. If you are to come, send me a message beforehand. I'll ask my mistress for a day off. Love letter to Dandelion, I'm sure. That's his loot, isn't it? That is L-U-T-E, not L-O-O-T.
This the loot he got from the elves of Dol Blathana.
Aye. Must have been in a great rush to leave it behind.
From the finest vineyards, every last one.
No one knows the fruit of the vine like Dandelion.
Letter from Bohmil de Rabbi? I don't know how to say that. Dear Viscount, or Viscount, once more, I would like to convey my thanks for agreeing to grace my son's wedding ceremony with your song. Your presence warmed our hearts, and the sweet notes with which you serenaded us so touched my wife's mother. The Baroness Duvlet, called in some circles a cold and heartless bitch, that tears of tender emotion appeared in her eyes.
The faculty of Oxenfurt University is honored to grant Julian Alfred Pancratz, Viscount de Letinov, the title of Master of the Seven Liberal Arts.
Keep forgetting he's got that damn fool name.
Oh, whoops. Tried to loot that, but that's my stash.
Annual balladry contest. Silver laurel awarded to Master Dandelion.
Prince Heriwood himself did the honors, and the feast afterwards, to celebrate the laureates. Dandelion taught a swine to yodel, and I... another time.
Another love letter, it looks like.
Hmm. 10 barrels of Toussaint Dry, 5 cases of sodden triple mead. Nothing here.
No! That's exactly what we're looking for! It's his planner!
Seems Dandelion's taking the tavern business seriously.
If you only knew. Gives it everything. No seen him this obsessed ever. Seems when he inherited this fine establishment, it came with some fine responsibilities. Bookkeeping among them. He also made a habit of noting down the times of his meetings, official and private. So, who'd he been seeing of late? Here it is. Seems he's only been meeting women of late, the dog.
Not a bad idea. Dandelion's pretty loose-lipped. Might have blabbed something to a lady friend that'll put us on his trail.
That's what I'm counting on. We should divide these somehow. Perhaps... fuck it. I'll ask the lassies in my half, you interrogate the ones in yours. Should you?
Zoltan, wait. This is in verse.
And you figure that's unnatural because...
Wonderful. Meet me back here when you're done. Share our findings.
Right, yeah. Need to do a wee bit of tidying before I go. Cannot stomach the idea of coming back to this mess. And you'd be wise to read your bit before you scurry off. If you need anything, I'll be next door.
Am I actually about to go just interrogate a bunch of Dandelion's lovers, or potential lovers, or admirers? If so, that's going to be a long, long list. Let's do some more looting first. Okay, I think that's everything on the ground floor. Would you stop? I thought you said you wanted to clean this place. You're just spitting all over the floor. Jesus, dude! He's spitting like every 5 seconds. Watch, he'll do it again right now. He just did it. Or he's coughing. I'm not sure. Yeah, he's spitting. Letter from a female admirer. The thrust of your hypnotic gaze left my visage red and hot. The whole world suddenly set to spinning in a whirlwind of oblivion, and I plunged into purest ecstasy. Wait, didn't I already see this? Didn't Geralt say this? Just, like, a minute ago? Yeah. Like a rose abashed of its crimson hue, fair Rosa would sink into humor's blue. She shunned her lessons in civility to swing her dwarf with agility. Molly, though well she knows the touch of silk and lace, she shuns not straw when gripped in lust's embrace. Wow. This is really his planner. Though timid in looks, no adventure did skip her. My heart melts when she asks, "Ever had a Big Dipper?" though her Maribella, though her cries are divine when behind closed doors, standing on stage, her squawks are drowned by snores. Elahal, a figure most rare, her natural duel, look deep in her eyes, or be made a fool. Am I really gonna have to go to every place? Oh my god. Fuck me. Dandelion, I hate you. This is gonna be like the adoring fan from Oblivion times 10. Also, let's loot the rest of this place. Damn! Although, most of it's probably just, like, water and random garbage. Yeah, cow's milk. It's just a bunch of garbage. Let's see if there's any chests. If there's a chest, it's probably worth looting. So just this one. Oh. Or that has water, too. Hmm. Yeah, it's not worth going in every room. Maybe we should go further upstairs. Hmm. It's locked. Curious. It's also kind of barred. It's got stuff in front of it. Alright, let's go meet Dandelion's fans.
What say we up over to a brothel this evening?
I don't even know you, sir. But I do think I should put my clothes back on.
Oh, let it go, Jared. Come on, we need another place to...
Oh my god. It's happening again.
Try the King of Beggars.
What? Look at me.
The Novigrad pedal.
I look like a plowing beggar to you. I'm a
heathen.
Junior claims you agreed to pay.
I will get you every last copper. With interest. Give me a week, please.
Horson's no banker. He's an honest man. You pay on time, you get protection. You don't pay.
Help!
What you hollering for, stupid wench? What are you hoping for? A knight in shining armor? Close enough.
Keep out of this, Greyhead. Not your concern.
Well, it seems we have a classic, stereotypical, cliched damsel in distress situation.
Vespula's got someone else's protection now.
Really? Who's that be?
Ooh. Ooh. I can invoke the King of Beggars' name. Or just do it myself. This might be an important decision down the line. Hmm. You know, I'm gonna say the King of Beggars. Because these people don't know me, but they know the King of Beggars. And they'll be afraid of him.
The King of Beggars made a deal with Junior. This is his turf now.
Didn't hear nothing about that.
But you have heard what Bedlam does to people who cross him. Or you need a demonstration.
Come on, Fritz. Boss wants it that way. It's how it's gotta be.
Thank you. Oh, thank you. To think there are men who'll help a stranger out of the kindness of their hearts.
Not entirely out of kindness, and you're not entirely a stranger.
What are you... Oh, I know you. You're that witcher took Dandelion out whoring.
What?
Gerald, right?
Excuse me? Gerald? Gerald?
Not Gerald. Geralt.
Oh. Dreadful sorry.
Explain something if you don't mind. You say I took Dandelion out whoring.
So he said. Claimed I was his one and only. but he fell in with the wrong folk. You and that dwarf who always looks like a cow licked him. Said you two were a bad example.
We're the bad example.
Song. He picked that habit up from us too. Gotta have a word with him. What do you think? Where could Dandelion be?
Probably out whoring. That horse pheasant. That lying scoundrel.
Ouch. What did he do to get your goat?
Same thing as ever. Prize bullshitter came back, saying it was till death do we part this time. And no more than a week passed before I spotted him in Harborside, strolling with some trollop on his arm. 'Twas the last straw. All those questions about the washerwomen at the bathhouse, then this. I beat him black and blue and threw him out on his ear.
Dandelion ask you about other washerwomen? Not terribly subtle even for him.
Maybe he likes some sudsy.
Maybe. But what did he ask about, exactly?
Oh, this and that, really. What's it like at the bathhouse? Have I got any friends there? What are their working hours? I don't know. Maybe he's looking to hire one for his tavern. Maybe I got all in a huff for no reason.
No, probably not. Really, you should stay away from Dandelion, because he is a piece of shit.
This woman he was with in the harbor. Who was she?
Claimed she was his niece from Covir. Ha! Horvir, more likely. Corset so tight her eyes were popping out her head. His too, come to think of it. An artist or a whore. Doesn't much matter as they're one in the same.
Okay. Alright, goodbye. I don't really like you very much either.
Thanks for your help. Listen, when I find Dandelion, anything I should tell him?
No. I mean, tell him he's a two-faced snake, but it would be nice if he dropped by.
I guess she doesn't hate him that much. Next. Dog. Koira.
Won't let them boss you around, eh?
Hey, look at this one.
You go your way, I'll go mine.
I think we're coming down.
Welcome, welcome. Do come in.
I'm a friend of Dandelion's, looking for Elihal.
You've come to the right spot. How might I be of service? Need something shortened? Patch your trousers, darn your socks.
You, Elihal?
Yes? Now pick your jaw up off the floor.
Sorry, I thought. Thought Elihal was one of Dandelion's girlfriends.
Oh, so it's that. Wait here.
Hmm?
Any better?
So you're
Elihal.
Did you and Dandelion, I mean, how did you two meet?
I met him one night in a tavern. He was blind drunk.
Oh my god, this is awesome! I was about to say that, it wouldn't surprise me if Dandelion was with Elihal, because, well, they're pretty damn pretty. Elves have that really nice bone structure. And that eyeshadow. Hmm.
What happened?
What do you think? We spoke.
That's it.
I'm not sure what you're getting at, but I should make one thing clear. Men don't interest me. Told him that as well. Luckily, Dandelion's an open-minded fellow. We had a lovely evening. He became a loyal customer afterwards.
Sorry, I'm just kind of speechless because I'm just really surprised that The Witcher 3 is actually handling this and that it actually has this in it, that it has somebody cross-dressing. I'm really surprised and really, really impressed. Because, like, normally in games or, well, even in really a lot of media of any sort, usually cross-dressing is just... It's handled really, really lazily and poorly, and it's just handled like a joke. You're like, haha, there's a dude in women's clothes, isn't that funny? Usually that's all it really is, and it's dumb and it's annoying. And it's pretty insulting. But I don't think they're actually doing that here. Like, it doesn't seem to be for comedic purposes or anything like that. It's just somebody who just likes to cross-dress. For whatever reason. I'm really, really impressed. I'm gonna ask them some questions and let's see where this goes.
I know this is none of my business, but
why do I dress up? As a child, I dreamt of becoming a Doppler when I grew up. I became a tailor instead. Discovered clothing. Costumes can express all the complexities of one's personality. I'm a Redanian countess one day, a dockside thug the next. That is true freedom.
Mm-hmm.
Have you never thought to become someone else? Even for a moment? Must be horribly boring being a witcher all the time.
I managed to stay interested.
Well, Geralt seems to be a douchebag about it, but yeah. This is actually really, really cool. Other than Geralt being a dickbag about it. He obviously doesn't understand. I'm really impressed with The Witcher 3. I mean, the writing's been generally good, but I don't know, it's kind of... You know, it's kind of a manly, masculine series, you know? You play as Geralt the White Wolf, slicing monsters and stuff, so... I kind of expected them to be pretty lazy when it came to subject matter like this, but they're actually doing a pretty damn good job with it. I'm impressed.
What did you and Dandelion talk about? He asked about anything in particular?
Let me think. Had an ordinary chat, really. Although... Indeed, he did keep asking about Kalkstein. If Dandelion and I hadn't laid our cards on the table at the start, I might have suspected he had a history with the alchemist. He spoke like a lovesick beau. In fact, he desperately wished to meet with him.
Kalkstein's in Novigrad? Wouldn't mind seeing him myself.
You're too late, I fear. The witch hunters nabbed him recently, burned him at the stake in Hierarch Square. But as he perished, ooh, the goings-on, impressive. Fiery beasts circled his pyre, then rose into the sky and exploded to form letters.
Really? What did they spell?
Radovid sucks flaccid cock.
Seriously? Oh.
Dandelion visit your shop often?
I tried many times to talk him into a decent doublet. Sadly, he'd only come in to get a button reaffixed or a hole patched.
When did you last see him?
Some time ago. He brought in one of Zoltan's jerkins, insisted I sew on an extra pocket. Odd as requests go, I had the distinct feeling he'd actually come to talk.
Thanks for your help, and nice to meet you.
I can help with much more. If you need new trousers or a vest, you know where to find me.
You know, I was actually wondering if you had any silver pants. Yeah, in fact, I am totally gonna ask you right now and see what they have in store and see if they have anything really pretty. In fact, can you sell me a dress? If I could put Geralt in a dress, I would be so happy. Let's take a look around at all these things first, though. Yeah, the clothing is so richly detailed in this game. It's really amazing.
Greetings. Come to look over my spring collection, perhaps?
I have. Oh, you play Gwent, too. Well, forget about that for now.
Glad to take a glance at what you got.
Of course, please do. If anything chafes or pinches, I can alter it on the spot at no charge. Once I'm done, it'll feel like you're wearing nothing at all.
Nothing at all. Nothing at all. Nothing. What is that? Wolf mask! Harlequin mask! Bird mask. Whoa. Okay, I want to buy this store. Can I buy this? I want to buy this store. Stuff's kind of heavy. Mildly heavy. Nilfgaardian trousers. Those might be the Rockstar pants that I accidentally sold. Ooh, this one's blue. You know what, good sir? I'm gonna buy this door. Thank you, good day.
So long.
Got the shivers.
Well, I think this is a pretty good place to end the episode. I'm gonna end it on a bit of a cliffhanger. A fashion cliffhanger. Because I have a whole wardrobe of new clothes and I can't wait to try it on. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far. And when I return, I'm gonna play dress up with Geralt.